Several Chicago police officers should be suspended or terminated for their role in a dehumanizing raid of an innocent woman's home 2 years ago, a new report from the city's Civilian Office of Police Accountability recommends. In February 2019, officers broke into the home of Anjanette Young, a black social worker who had just returned home from work. She was naked, alone, and hadn't committed any crime. Police had mistakenly identified the wrong apartment in executing a search warrant. Footage from police body cameras, released in December 2020 by CBS Chicago, shows officers smashing Young's door with a battering ram and barging into her home with guns drawn. They handcuffed her while she was naked, and attempted to cover her in blankets that continued to slide off, while she repeatedly screamed, sobbed, and told officers they were at the wrong home. "It's one of those moments where I felt I could have died that night," Young told WBBM-TV. "Like if I would have made one wrong move, it felt like they would have shot me. I truly believe they would have shot me." Police let Young put clothes on after 10 minutes had passed, and held her in handcuffs for 10 more minutes before accepting she had no connection to the target of the search warrant, the police accountability report says. The officers were in her home for over an hour in total. The report traces nearly 100 allegations of misconduct against 15 involved officers, concluding that many of them violated applicable laws and policies, including knock and announce guidance that failed to let Young clothe herself before police entered her home. Three officers failed to activate their body cameras, the report found. None of them had received more than a few hours of warrant-related training since leaving the police academy, it says. The report singled out Officer Alain Aporongao, the officer who signed the affidavit supporting the warrant application. Aporongao didn't cooperate with the investigation and refused to identify other department employees who helped him with the warrant investigation and approval, the report says. It also noted that Sergeant Alex Wolinski, who with Aporongao, didn't present the search warrant to Young and failed to take reasonable actions to protect her dignity in keeping her handcuffed naked for at least 10 minutes. The report recommended that Aporongao face a minimum 180-day suspension, and Wolinski a minimum year-long suspension. It also recommended Sergeant Cory Petracco, who was not present at the raid, but supervised Aporongao and is held out as a leader in the department, face a minimum year-long suspension.